This is seed-grown wasabi, and there's going to be a whole lot of variation between plants. So what we need to do in America probably is grow a lot of seedlings, dig them up, and pick out the best ones, and then start tissue culture. In Japan, it is all cultivated by tissue culture of specific selected clones. And those clones have been selected to have big, bright green, flavorful roots. So they don't do this in Japan. So these are all divisions from, this was two plants. So now I'm going to have about 12 or 13. I also suspect that root cuttings of these little rhizomes would make new plants. The rhizomes are not very big, unfortunately. But I'm guessing I could cut that into three or four pieces, and each one would make me a new plant. So that would be an alternative to doing it from seed. And those plants would be a little bit bigger as well. The rhizomes are covered with little tiny bumps, which I suspect each one of those bumps is capable of becoming an adventitious bud and sprouting out leaves. So from that one right there, it'll probably make five or six root cuttings. So this is kind of experimental. I've been meaning to do this for a while. We'll just see what happens. I would like to try and see if we can propagate this from root cuttings. So I'm going to take one right there, another one here, another one here. So that's how big I'm going to make these cuttings, trying different sizes actually. And then we'll just put this back. So. This is just my regular woodland potting mix, which is composed mostly of bark and leaf mold with a little bit of perlite in it for drainage.